Good morning friends, welcome in this class. This video is for class 7, subject social science. As we are studying about history chapter 5, rulers and buildings. It is the second lecture of this chapter, and in today's lecture the topics are to be discussed. First one, engineering skill and construction, building temple, mosque and tanks, why were temple destroyed, gardens, tombs and forts. So let's we start today's discussion. Yes friends, in our previous lecture, yesterday lecture, we have studied about some buildings and about their constructions technique. Ki many buildings were built in India by different rulers, like by Mughal rulers, Hindu rulers, according to their interest. Okay. And they used different techniques. We discussed that in the starting, the technique which was used in the buildings, that was the terra beach. And the second technique was there, that was arkgrate. Now we will discuss about these two techniques which were used by in the constructions of buildings. Okay, yes, engineering skills and construction. Monuments provide an insight to the technologies used for constructions. Means by looking the monuments, we can come to know about the new techniques, new technologies which were used in the construction work. Between the 7th and 10th centuries, architects started adding more rooms, doors and windows to buildings. Means with the passage of time, or up to the 10th centuries, now architectures, they started to build or add more rooms, they started to add more doors and windows in these buildings. Okay, and roofs, doors and windows were made by placing a horizontal beam across two vertical columns, a style of architecture called terabit or corbelled. Yes friends, yesterday I also told you about the terabit. Actually, this was a technique which was used in the constructions of building, and especially for lying roof. So how the roof was lying? Actually, for that, four beams, or the column you can say, okay, horizontal beams were placed at the floor, okay, ground floor. And on this horizontal beam, then two vertical columns, okay, or slab you can say, two vertical slabs were lying on this horizontal beam. This technique was known as terabit architecture technique. Okay, technological and stylistic development. Two noticeable technologic and stylistic development from the 12th centuries. First, architectural form called arcuate. First one was there, terabit, and the second techniques which means new technique which was introduced, that was arcuate. The weight of the superstructure. Yes friends, I have already told the meaning of superstructure, means the above part, okay, of any buildings, topmost part of any building. Above the doors and windows were sometimes carried by arc. Yes friends, you can understood the meaning of arc, like some times you use this in your mathematics also, like when you draw any angle, so at that time with the help of compass that you draw arc. Okay, means you can say half circle, curve shape. Okay, so this type of design were also started to use in the constructions of buildings. So nowadays also we see that arcuate architecture styles in our house also, like in the halls of the rooms. Okay, and the second things which were introduced earlier, the you can say sandstone was used in the constructions of building, but now high quality, good quality limestone cement was used. And in the cement, like stone pieces, chips, hardened concrete was used, okay, which gave the hardened to the, okay, strong to this building constructions. So help make the construction large structure easier and faster. So now question is there, which were two technological and stylistic development which developed during the 12th centuries. Yes, the first technological development was there, that was arcuate technique, and second was there, that was the limestone cement was introduced. Understood about these two technological and stylistic development? Yes, friends. Now, difference between terabit and arcade. This I told you two types of the technique, architectural technique. First one is terabit and second one arcade. Terabit principle of architecture, roofs, doors and windows were made by placing a horizontal beam across two vertical column. And in arcade, just I told, principle of architecture, the weight of the superstructure, big buildings above the doors and windows was sometimes carried by earth. Now I will show picture. After that, you can come understood difference between these two techniques. Okay. So, now give a look on it. Yes, first picture is related to the terabit technique and second is related to the arcade technique. Terabit technique, in which you see that horizontal beams are first lying on the ground floor, okay, and after that two vertical slabs are lying on these horizontal beams. So this type of techniques is known as terabit technique, okay, and after that roof was made. And in arcade technique, you can say arc shape entrance is there. Okay, so in which the weight of the door, entrance gate or the windows were lying on the arc. I think students, now you have understood about these two different techniques, terabit technique and arcade techniques. So you must know about it. Related to this topic, I have given one question answer, ki difference between terabit and arcade techniques. So I think understood ki in terabit techniques that first two horizontal beams are lying on the floor and after that the two vertical slabs are lying on it. Okay. And in arcade, the weight of the windows and doors, okay, is lying on the arc. Got it, beta? So these two technologies and stylistic development from the 12th centuries are arcade architectural form and use of limestone mixed with stone chips that led to faster constructions. So assimilations of Indian style were with Persian styles of architecture was prominent. Okay, now we will discuss about some building, temples, mosques and tanks. Okay friends, beta, before it we discussed about the private building. Now we will discuss about the temples, mosque, tank, means public buildings. The buildings which were made by for public facilities, public use. Temple, mosque were beautifully constructed because they were places of worship and meant to demonstrate the power, wealth, devotion of the patron, lover of art. Sometimes these rulers constructed this type of building or the building for the public to gain, you can say, praise. To gain praise from the common people, and they wanted to demonstrate, they wanted to show their richness, their wealth, their power, their devotion to the gods. That's why also they constructed and misbuilt many buildings. Yes, now I will give one example. Yes, I have told about the Rajrajeshwara temple. We have studied about it, that Rajrajeshwara temple, it is located in Kerala. And in which one inscription mentioned that it was built by King Raja Rajadeva for the worship of his god Raja Rajeshwaram. So here we can see that the means common, you can see that features in the name of the god and the ruler. Okay, so means they wanted to gain praise. That's why also they constructed temples and mosques. And they wanted to show the their devotion towards the god. Okay, so the king took the god's name because it was auspicious and he wanted to appear like a god. Okay, through the rituals of worship in the temple, one god, Raja Rajadeva, honored another, Raja Rajeshwaram. Understood? So means it is saying that at that time, the rulers were also considered as god. Okay, so here it is shown that Raja Deva, who is also considered like god. So this Raja Deva god, that he honored or he worshipped another god, that was Raja Rajeshwaram. Okay, so means the rulers also had miss importance, or you can say that personality like god. okay? Yes. So the largest temples were all constructed by kings. The other lesser deities in the temples were gods and goddesses of the allies and the subordinate of the rulers. Yes, that difference was also found. Okay, means the temples which were largest, and in these largest temples, the chief deities, okay, images were kept and they were worshipped by only the rich class, okay, ruler categories also. And in the small temples, lesser deities were, images of lesser deities, okay, were kept and they were considered, or they were, you can say, worshipped by the subordinate, other family members of the ruler. Muslim sultans and badshahs did not claim to be incarnations of the god, but Persian court chronicles describe the sultan as the shadow of the god. And if we talk about the Muslim sultans and the badshahs, means they didn't claim themselves that they were the incarnation of god. Yes friends, incarnation means avatar, okay? But they declared them, but the Persian court chronicles, means these inscriptions which give the information about these rulers, means in this inscription it is described that sultans, like, means they were not the creations of the god, means incarnations of the god, but they were considered as the shadow of the god. Understood? Yes. Muslim Sultan Basha, just I told, did not claim to be incarnation of the god, but Persian court chronicles describe Sultan as the shadow of the god. As each new dynasty came to power, kings wanted to emphasize their moral rights to be ruler. Okay, and so it was widely believed that the rule of a king just would be an age of plenty when the heavens would not withhold rain. Okay, means when all these rulers then they worship, it's look that the really the gods that came on the earth. Why were temple destroyed? Yes friends, ki the ruler constructed these temples also, and some temples were destroyed by the rulers themselves. Ki jahan कुछ टेम्पल्स रूलर्स ने बनाए तो कुछ टेम्पल्स को रूलर ने डिस्ट्रॉय भी किया. व्हाट वाज द रीजन व्हाई वर टेम्पल्स डिस्ट्रॉयड? एज आई टोल्ड बेटा कि द रूलर्स दैट दे कंस्ट्रक्टेड टेम्पल्स टू शो देयर वेल्थ, देयर रिचनेस, देयर पावर, देयर डिवोशन टू गॉड्स. सो मीन्स व्हेन दे अटैक्ड ऑन द अदर किंगडम्स ऑफ अदर रूलर्स, देन दे डिस्ट्रॉयड दिस temples also to destroy their power and wealth. Okay, so in the early 18th centuries, when the Chola king Rajendra I built a Shiva temple in his capital, he filled it with the prize statues seized from defeated rulers. Okay, ki means the one temple which was built by the king Rajendra, so when he was defeated by the other rulers, so the statues and priests were seized. Okay, so beta, in this way actually we have discussed our today's lectures, okay, today's topics. Now I'll give you question answer. Yes friends, how is the terabit principles of architecture different from arcade? Actually by mistake beta, I have not given the numbering of the questions. Okay, so put it yourself. Today 4 questions are there, in which first is there, how is the terabit principles of architecture different from arcade, and why were temples destroyed? This is the second question. Both we have discussed ki why temples were destroyed, to that destroy the wealth of the or devotions of the other rulers. Write a short note on Qutub Minar. Okay, and what types of architects found between 7th and 10th centuries? So about all this question we have discussed in our lecture. Okay, so the answer of this question you have to write in your fair notebook, and after completion you have to submit it to me on my email ID. Understood? Now we will have a discussion on homework solution. Yesterday the question answer which were given, in which first is there, explain the term Mahamandap. It refers to the main hall of the temple where dances were performed. What is superstructure? Superstructure refers to the part of a building above the ground floor. Who built Jama Masjid? Jama Masjid was built by Shahjahan in his new capital at Shahzabad. Who built Rajrajeshwara temple? It was built by King Raja Rajadeva for the worship of his god Raja Rajeshwaram. Who constructed Kandariya Mahadeva temple and when? Kandariya Mahadeva temple dedicated to Shiva, and it was constructed in 999 by the king Dangdeva of Chandela dynasty. Write a short note on Kandariya temple. The Kandariya Mahadeva temple dedicated to Shiva was constructed in 999 and by the king Dangdeva of Chandela dynasty. An ornamented gateway led to an entrance and the main hall Mahamandap, where dances were performed, and the image of the chief deity was kept in the main shrine Garbhagira, and this was the place for ritual worship where only the king, his immediate family and priest gathers. So friends, in this way our today's lecture is completed. Tomorrow we will meet again with our next lecture with next topic. Thank you.